Hello, it's Polish Paul VR. Welcome to the channel. I hope you all alright and having good day. We are here to do some more PlayStation VR news. We're gonna talk about a content update for Arizona Sunshine for Totally Free and also update for Gun Club VR for Totally Free. Bit of information about Half-Life Alyx and also No Man's Sky. So let's just jump into it and maybe let's start from the Arizona Sunshine. The developer announced that they releasing brand new map for the game, Trailer Park. It's placed to you in the background, so Arizona Sunshine of course had some DLCs, but also Arizona Sunshine is a game which got very nice co-op Horde mode. And this brand new map, it is for Horde mode, it's gonna be for free. It's releasing today on other platform, but Vertigo Games announced that PlayStation VR owner is gonna get it as well, just a bit later, probably early next year. And also, while we're talking about Vertigo Games, I want to come back to this studio because, as we know, they developing a very, very good looking game after the fall, but what's happening is the game is slightly delayed. I was asked yesterday in my comment section what's going on. So yeah, After the Fall won't be releasing this year. I already done news video, I think, month or so ago about it. But yeah, that's what happened with this game, but nevertheless, I'm sure it's going to be great when it comes out. So Vertigo Games not only been making Arizona Sunshine, but also they've got into publishing. So, you know, they're gonna release Traffic Jams, which sadly got delayed as well. And also lately they announced they're gonna release for Quest Hunt Tracking Air Guitar Game, which probably going to be cool. But definitely their biggest project, the one that they developing in-house themselves, is After the Fall, and that's gonna be with us next year. So this is gonna be like online co-op looter shooter. Think about it, maybe kind of like Borderlands, but this time you can play with friends. So that's gonna be a blast. But of course, while you're waiting, fire up Arizona Sunshine, get somebody to play with you, and download this new map once it releases on PlayStation VR, and just have fun. Okay, anyway, moving on to the another story and another game, I want to talk a bit about Gun Club VR. Now, this game had tons of updates already. Binary Mill is one of those studios what likes to release a very good game, but then suddenly surprise the players with some updates which are totally free, which is very nice of them. So what's happening with the Gun Club VR? The SWAT update is coming. So in this update you get new SWAT weapons, but also they saying they're gonna add new locomotion system, which is very nice. Now the update, as with everything else, pretty much other platforms gonna get it now, but also the developer said they do not forgetting about PlayStation VR owners, and PlayStation VR owners will get this update soon as well. But as always, it takes a bit longer to develop for PSVR. I'm assuming that's something to do with Sony's QA, but also with different way that the game's getting developed on consoles. But nevertheless, this update will be coming soon. Probably, like with Arizona Sunshine, it's gonna be with you early next year. If you don't play Gun Club VR, it's a very, very good game. You've got like tons of weapons what you can play with. And you're just about to get a bit more very kind of like realistic reloading mechanics and all the weapons physics and everything. So yeah, it's also got very nice kind of gameplay time. It lasts for a longer amount of time than most PlayStation VR games, so that's nice as well. And also it sells for very cheap. So I'm assuming some of you who's got this game know what I'm talking about. If you don't have it, I advise pick it up, because this game, even though it's an older title now, it's keep getting updated. Okay, anyway, now let's move on to the next story and let's talk a bit about No Man's Sky VR. So what's happening with this game is yesterday during the Game Awards, the developer Hello Games, they won the Best Ongoing Game Award, and that comes of course because they just supporting this game so much, giving it so many updates, like your, you know, VR update, which is awesome. But also what's happening with it, there is some more updates due to release for No Man's Sky. We don't know what it is yet, but we probably gonna find out soon. When it comes to PSVR version, I know there is some issues with blurriness, but hey, what can you do? and I'm sure as soon as Hello Games can do it, they probably will release a proper PlayStation 5 patch. As of now, they released next-gen update for Flatgame because it was possible for them to do so, but sadly PSVR kind of work through this backwards compatibility. I'm assuming maybe they could run dynamic resolution as some games does, but my thinking is they already do got dynamic resolution running and maybe they are a bit held back by this backwards compatibility mode on PS5. Even though it does improves some games, it's still not unleashing this proper big power of PlayStation 5 console. So we just gonna have to wait. I'm sure Sony gonna announce something eventually. But as of now, congratulations to the studio. And also, while we're here, speaking about the Game Awards, the best VR game of the year is Half-Life Alyx. I was thinking it's gonna be kind of between Half-Life Alyx and Dreams, because both very huge milestones in VR. But Half-Life Alyx took the crown. Now, I want to talk about Half-Life Alyx as well, because in past the thinking was, maybe when PlayStation 5 drops, then we're gonna get the port of the game on PlayStation VR. Of course, now we know that's not the case, but what's happening is, even if Sony unlocks this PS5 power to, run the game on PlayStation VR on PS5, I'm assuming we're still not gonna get it. My best guess is, to get Half-Life Alyx on PSVR, we definitely have to wait for new headset, or even if not new headset, definitely new controllers. On PC, this game running using state-of-the-art controllers and state-of-the-art tracking, and sadly PSVR kind of don't do it, especially with Move controllers, so I'm assuming even if power was here, they still wouldn't be able to port it, just because the game wouldn't feel as the developers intended. But also to keep all your good hopes up, the studio, they already said they want as many people as possible to experience this game. They never excluded console port. Of course, only console supporting VR at the moment is PlayStation. So hopefully whenever Sony announces new headsets or new controllers, hopefully then we're gonna hear some news from Valve about Half-Life Alyx coming to PlayStation VR. This is such a good game, and it's definitely all this hard work what the developers put into it. It definitely would pay off better if more people could play it, because of course not everyone can get a super awesome massive extra fast gaming PC with the best headset, which is Valve Index, spend so much money on it. While on console, kind of market is a bit bigger, but also hardware now is lagging a bit behind. So I do hope for some announcements from Sony in the future. And also I'll be having my fingers crossed about Half-Life Alyx to come to PlayStation VR. But I wanted to mention this game in this video because of course VR Game of the Year award is very good for them and definitely something what team deserves, but also I wanted to update you about possibility of this game coming to PlayStation VR. Okay, anyway, that's it. So before I go, if you want to check out my second channel, Assassin's Creed Village, I do flat gaming news down there and also playing some flat games. I'll be back later on tonight with some Cyberpunk 2077. Yesterday I played it on original PS4, it was alright, it's not as bad, it's playable, but I'll be back on PS5 today just to play this game in 60 frames per second, because that of course is definitely a better way to play it, and also I'll be back with different games as well, and a lot of Assassin's Creed stuff down there. But anyway, if you like what you're seeing, then please press a like, because it does helps the channel a lot. And if you're new to the channel and are not subscribed, then subscribe. It's always better when it's more of us. And that's it, bye.